Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here and coming to you from FEMA Region 4 of the North American continent. Brothers and sisters, hope you guys are doing all right. This is Brother Patrick coming to you from South Carolina. Just praising the Lord today, even though it's cold here. I think most of the United States is colder than it is here, down here in southeastern South Carolina. So praise God for that. The sun is shining here. It's about 45 degrees. So thank the Lord for sunshine. I don't see any chemtrails in the sky this morning. So praise God for that. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I hope you guys are doing all right. I'm talking all this conspiracy stuff. even though it's all true, brothers and sisters, I have a relative who I went to the church last week, and my relative, he goes there to that church that I visited, and he had just, sent me a, tagged me in a post on Facebook, and the post was from a former CNBC commentator who is now Fox Business News, and she was saying how she had said on CNBC on the air that the Obamacare thing was no way, that it would work. People would lose their doctor, that they would cost millions and millions of more dollars, and Obamacare would not work. And she was called on the to the head cheeses there at CNBC, and they scolded her and got on to her and said she was being disrespectful to the office of the presidency and all this for saying that his policy was gonna not work. His proposed at that time proposed legislation of what we call Obamacare or the Affordable Health Care Act, which is real funny. They call it the Affordable Health Care Act. You know how the devil is good at picking names? And you know how I love to change topics. I should change topics on this point. They call the Affordable Health Care Act, when in reality it made everybody's prices go up. And then on the Republican side, they came out with the Patriot Act, when in reality, if you don't support this, you're not a patriot. I mean, that's the implication. But in reality, it gives them a right, even though we know that there's some wicked people who might come here and try to plot some kind of a bombing and all that. But in reality, they've used it, which, what Snowden revealed, and that stuff's been out for years, for 20 years on the internet, or, since they've had the internet, there's been inside whistleblowers reporting like Fast and Furious. It would not have been reported if it wasn't for a whistleblower. And of course, he was punished for being a whistleblower. All the whistleblowers are always punished, right? The establishment and the powers that be who are always corrupt. It's just how corrupt are they? That's the only question. They always go after people. So, and then abortion, as I made a video the other day, they call it pro-choice. And then Christians, they counter that with pro-life. But what the liberals will say, the baby killers, those who should be ashamed to say anything bad about Hitler, because at least Hitler didn't, kill his own flesh and blood as a pregnant woman and man, and then if the man is involved, which, sometimes he is, sometimes he's not. People making a decision to kill their own flesh and blood. I mean, Satan, that's got to be straight from Satan. Hitler doesn't have anything on that. But they have the audacity and the insanity to call it pro-choice. Yeah, you have a choice to kill your own flesh and blood. So when I say that, I just want to put the Obamacare into perspective. I want to even put the Patriot Act, which is much worse than Obamacare. People are talking bad about Obamacare, and then this, which was really an urban, thing, saying that everybody had to have a chip, and they were saying it was by March 2013, and that would be the mark of the beast. Well, that's long been gone. And even though Obamacare is a step toward the New World Order and a step toward, bringing in control of people, and yes, I'm sure that, that'll all be interconnected with the Mark of the Beast and all that, it's just a little step. The Patriot Act is a much bigger step on that scale of bringing in the New World Order. The Patriot Act, fruit of, is really a controlling and spying on everybody, which I just posted a link on Facebook because, when I see something that's pertaining to end times, I'll usually, posted on my Facebook wall, just a FYI for those who might see it. Now it's coming out, the New York Times is reporting that, the government is doing all this infiltration, posing as pastors, which I already knew that for years, that was really exposed back at the time of Katrina in New Orleans, that there are over 50,000 American pastors who are on the take from the Homeland Security. And then their job is to tell people, and they even use Bible verses, Romans 13, telling people they need to submit to the government. Now, those same people who are part of Christendom are nominal Christianity, in name only, not truly born-again Christians, which it seems to be the vast majority of people who claim to be Christians are not, and particularly those in leadership. Those are the very ones who will be telling people, oh, take the mark, this is not the mark of the beast, oh, the Bible's not literal, it's all metaphoric, no, this is for your own good, and turning your weapons, and they use the Bible against you, Romans chapter 13, taking it out of context. Brothers and sisters, you know, America was founded, and as I mentioned before, the great awakening that God sent through men like John Wesley, who founded the Methodist Church, which is now, of course, nothing but a mere shell of what it, you know, of nothingness compared to what it was in the time of John Wesley. Those men of God, you know, really instilled, you know, the wisdom of liberty, which comes from God. The Bible says that, you know, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So, you know, God, you know, America, even in the concept, is a Judeo-Christian concept of liberty, that all men are created equal. And it says that they're endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights. They cannot be removed from you. It comes from the Creator, not from government. That's the difference, really, between, if you look at the modern-day government, of course, and I don't say the word necessarily Republican, because there's lots of Republicans who are, they call them rhinos, Republican in name only, just like there are pastors who are pastors in name only. So you have conservatives or libertarians, and then you have your people who think this better living through government is God. You know, and that's, you know, the antithesis of the, you know, the exact opposite and the spirit of Antichrist. Whereas the founding fathers wrote in the document, really inspired by God, to say that we are endowed by our Creator with rights that cannot be taken from us. God has given us. And some of these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. These are God-given rights, not from some king, earthly king. Even as Israel sinned against God and said, we want a king over us, God said, hey, I'm your king. But they wanted a human king, so God sent them King Saul as a judgment. Just like God has sent us Obama as a judgment, you know, to show us our ways. But brothers and sisters, as I mentioned earlier in this video, I know that many of you are caught up in the and believe that wrestling is real. You know, WWF, Worldwide Wrestling Federation, all that. Some of you guys really think that's real. And I want to tell you, a politics is just like a Worldwide Wrestling Association. It's about 99% fake, brothers and sisters. They go through the motions and they say the right things, but 99% of them have sold their soul to the devil, and they'll do the devil's bidding no matter what title they have on their name. But in saying that, it's also true, anybody which would support pro-choice or pro-killing your own baby is definitely on the other team. But there are some on the Republican side who are really, as an example, a great example and a great issue and a simple, clear, black and white issue of abortion, there are some Republicans who are really Christians who are trying to make a change and make America a Christian nation. Some, not that many. Most of them are establishment people, sold their soul to the devil, and they just have a different route to bring in the new world order, brothers and sisters. And you know, I think I did mention this in the book the Lord gave me to write. I can't remember if I did or not, but I should write about it. I try not to get into politics too much, but it's really like this. There's two camps in the world of the Euro-American structure, brothers and sisters. There's two camps. And on the liberal side, like Jimmy Carter, he is a member of the Trilateral Commission. And you have this Benigzu Brzezinski. His daughter is, you know, a commentator on the Morning Joe on MSNBC. MSNBC, of course, is lined up with that category. And what they are is what they call Fabian Socialist. You know, and you've got Bill Clinton. Of course, Bill Clinton is a one worder for him, you know, and he's a megalomaniac. It's all about him. But you've got the former Prime Minister of England, Tony Blair. He's in that, you know, a big figure in that area of this, what they call Fabian Socialist. And their symbol is a turtle. And it's to slowly turn the world into a one world new order. And then on the alleged conservative side, you have what they call the Anglo-American Empire. So they want a new world order with America and, you know, the neocons. I'm touching on all these topics. You got Bill Kristol. His dad was a founding member of that. They call them Trotskyites. They're you can look this up too. They say they're Jews, but they're not. They're Ashkenazi Jews from New York City, but they're not really Jews. They're from a tribe in Russia. That's why you see all these Russians. They're not really Jewish, like the Rothschilds and that. They're not really Jewish. They converted to Judaism, but they're not from the tribes of Israel. Most of the people from that Eastern European area. And then that's where the Rothschilds and all these people come from. You can look any of these things up. So those neocons, they call them, are really communist liberals who have become war hawks. Like that gay guy from Harper's Vanity Fair or whatever his name is, that died of AIDS, who was such a big God hater. He was a neocon. You've got all these people in that camp, the neocon camp. They have no morality. They're not Christian, Judeo-Christian based morality people who are conservative. They're war hawks. They want to dominate the world through the Anglo-American, which is the British American, European model of dominating the world. And then on the Obama side, they want to divide up the world and have it a communist thing, and have more of other countries influencing it. That's why they call it a trilateral, to divide the world into three different regions, like Asia, Europe, and America, whatever. They've got a trilateral thing. So that's just the difference. But they both have the same goal of a new world order. Says, which path do you take to get there? As an example, brothers and sisters, Adolf Hitler was funded by these people who claim they're Jewish, the Rothschilds, the Warburger brothers. These people, they claim to be Jews, but they're not. They're Ashkenazi Jews, a tribe in Russia that converted. You can go look this up, like 700 or 800 AD. They funded Adolf Hitler. They funded Lenin. Lenin was an Ashkenazi Jew. Lenin, who did the Russian Revolution. Okay, so if you look at the real history, this is the kind of things that happen, brothers and sisters, because they're trying to bring the New World Order. Now, what Hitler did, Hitler is one of the best, if not the best, type of Antichrist outside the Bible. He marked the Jewish people. He tried to have them, all killed and all this stuff, but it led to them returning back to their land. So, God allowed this controlled opposition to happen, and the fruit of it was, it really ushered in the last days with Israel to return as a nation. But brothers and sisters, Hitler, all Hitler did was, of course, I'm totally against Hitler, okay? I'm just saying what he did. He's not the only one with blood on his hands. That's what I'm saying. He took the ideas of Darwin. He's basically saying that, his people were saying that, the Aryans were the master race. Go look at the stuff that those Nazis were saying. We're the master race. We have superiority over these inferior races of people, the Jews, black people, people, the Slavic people, the Russian people, all these people. We're a racially superior to them, and therefore we will dominate and conquer them, and we will have a master race, and we'll rule the world for 1,000 years. That is the same kind of stuff the Antichrist is going to be saying, brothers and sisters. But, he's going to do it on a more broad scale to be more inclusive. But the same concept comes from Darwinism. Natural selection and all this, manifest destiny. Adolf Hitler got his ideas from American politicians. Before, they used to sterilize, people that were mentally handicapped, and then Margaret Sanger, who started the Planned Parenthood. Go read her quotes. She said, I'm doing this because we need to get rid of the inferior races, particularly black people. She was pushing for abortion and birth control for black people because she wanted to get rid of the race. This is the ideas that Hitler just took and ran with it. And what he did is Roosevelt and the communist Russians and the British leadership, they were all Fabian socialists, just like Obama. Roosevelt was also lined up in that same thing of, the socialist side of things, the left-wing side of New World Order. President Roosevelt wanted a New World Order. That's why he was the one who commissioned, under the advice of his Secretary of Agriculture, Henry Wallace, he's the one that put the official seal of the United States on the back of the dollar bill with the all-seeing eye and all that stuff, and announcing the age of the New World Order right there in Latin on the back of the money, which was recreated back there by Thomas Jefferson and those other guys. They made that back at the time of the Revolution, but it was not used anywhere. And then Henry Wallace, I've mentioned this in videos before, I'm getting into all this political stuff. Henry Wallace, the Secretary of Agriculture, he had a guru. You can go look these things up. These things are awesome to look at. He had a guru named Nicholas Roerich, who is really a Satanist and a wicked, wicked man, who, if you want to see, what the Antichrist is going to do, you need to look at the stuff he was saying. He was hearing from Satan. And Nicholas Roerich was the guru of this Henry Wallace. Henry Wallace even ran for president, and of course, or his vice president. What ruined his career was, the letters he wrote to his guru, and he called him guru, you know, it got out, you know, to the public, and that's why it really ruined his career. But this Henry Wallace, this character, you know, and his guru, they wanted to bring in the New Atlantis. Now, where they got that idea from? It goes way back, really through Francis Bacon, Sir Francis Bacon, Rosicrucians, back to the Knights Templar, Freemasons, all that. It's all interconnected, brothers and sisters. I've mentioned this in other videos, and I'm just skipping all this information. You know how it is. But because obviously the Lord wants me to talk about it. But anyway, brothers and sisters, these two different camps. And then so you've got the Roosevelt camp, and the before Churchill, there's, you know, this... the other prime minister, Chamberlain, who said there will be peace in our time. Those guys and the Russians, they want to have a new world order, but they want to have it through the Fabian socialist, the slow turtle moving, you know, as they say, the metaphor or the story, if you put a frog in water and then you slowly heat it, he won't realize that it's boiling, but if and he'll die. But if you put a frog in the boiling water, he'll jump out. You know, that's the way they see things. They're trying to do it. Still the same thing through the Democrats in America. They're the you know the offspring of that branch of the devil's plan. Bring it through this socialist, you know, uniting all the world with equality of pay and all this kind of communist socialist ideas. And then on the other side you have the imperialistic, like what Hitler tried to do, fascism. And then you know that's what Hitler was doing, like what really American Republicans, but much worse. But the American Republicans, generally speaking, are lined up, the neocons particularly, Bill Kristol and these other people, not the actor Billy Crystal, Bill Kristol, and those neocons, they're lined up with that idea of world domination through the Anglo-American Empire. Now, Hitler tried to do the same thing, but with Germany. And he just got ahead of what they wanted him to do. He did exactly their, you know, the devil's plan on the fascist side. But, you know, it wasn't time. God didn't allow it to go forward. So, I mean, that's the good news in all this. What I'm trying to tell you is on that Facebook link, my cousin asked me to comment about, you know, the MSNBC or CNBC censoring this woman. And then she went to Fox Business when it started. And, you know, I was telling him, you know, both sides are working together to bring in a new world order. So all of the people that have the money, these Ashkenazi Jewish people, not the real Jewish people, that's why people are talking about it, these Rothschilds and people like that, these are the real people that run the world. As a matter of fact, as I mentioned, I think before, it was either, I think it's J.P. Morgan, but it could have been Carnegie, but I think 99% it was J.P. Morgan. When he died, it was revealed that he only owned like 10 or 20% of all of his companies. The rest was owned by the Rothschilds. So these people, these wealthy Gentiles that you hear about, most of them are just front men for the Rothschild family. And ultimately, you know, they've got the last names of their different descendants and stuff. You'd have to go research it out. But they, you know, hold trillions of dollars, trillions of dollars. These things that you hear about Bill Gates and all that, he's only, you know, Bill Gates' dad was a lawyer for Planned Parenthood in Washington State. You know, these people, and Bill Gates is an atheist, and they want to kill everybody. You know, he's just a boy, a front man, you know, a Gentile face on what the Rothschilds are trying to do. He's just a face, you know, he's just a front man for the things they do. And so was J.P. Morgan and these other people. Go look it up yourself. Go study. You can find out all these things are to be true, brothers and sisters. When the devil does everything, it's always with deception. So I made this comment on his video, and then I realized how dark was the comment, like what I'm telling you guys. And then I said, well, you know what? But the good news is there is always liberty in Jesus Christ. For with the Spirit of the Lord is there is liberty. We always can overcome all of these schemes of men and their God, the devil, through the blood of Jesus, through deliverance through Jesus Christ. And, of course, that's the end result. That's the whole point. So, brothers and sisters, I'm making this video because there's many of you who you see all these things, but you don't, you know, you're not prioritizing it in your life. You know, you're getting caught up in the left-right paradigm. You're getting caught up in the WWF of world politics and American politics, wherever country you're from, not realizing that, you know, Jesus said Satan is, you know, the god of this world. And the Bible says he's the prince and power of the air. And so the kingdoms of this world, as Satan told Jesus when Jesus was tempted, Satan said, you know, if you will bow down and worship me, I will give you all these kingdoms. He said that Satan showed Jesus all the kingdoms in a moment. He showed him all the great kingdoms of the history of the world and said, if you bow down and worship me, I'll give you all of these. You know, Jesus didn't say, no, you don't have that authority. Jesus didn't say that. No, Jesus said, thou shalt worship the Lord your God and him only. But he didn't say, oh, Satan, you're wrong. You don't have that authority. Because it says right in the text that Satan had that authority, which he does. He has the authority over the kingdoms of man until Jesus returns. That's the whole reason why Jesus is coming back. Because right now, under the fallen creation, God has cursed the creation. He's cursed man, he cursed the woman, he cursed the ground, and it's under the curse. But now when we get saved, we are spiritually redeemed. We receive the earnest or deposit of the Holy Spirit in our heart. We're sealed with the Holy Spirit when we're saved. But our flesh is flesh indeed. And sickness comes upon us indeed. And all those things in this world, we're still in a fallen world, brothers and sisters. All of these politicians, as I said, for most of you guys who are Christian, you're conservative. Did President Bush overturn Roe v. Wade? No, he did not. Did he do anything to stop it? No, he appointed Supreme Court justices who sided with Obamacare. The head guy, Roberts, go research him and how he got an instant family when it was time for him to be on the Supreme Court. These people are all... they all have some secret life, brothers and sisters. Almost all of them have sold their soul to the devil. Either they're homosexuals and they're trying to keep it secret, they're on drugs, or both. They've been bribed, all those things. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely, brothers and sisters. Except in the case of the Lord Jesus Christ himself, and those by the grace of God are able to make it through, you know, without being overcome with greed, lust, and all these other things that can overtake us and easily beset us, as the Bible says, in this world, brothers and sisters. That's why we must be forever more humble and humble ourselves, for God gives grace to the humble, but he resists the proud. So thank God, you know, that God knows the limit of how much, you know, power in this world we can have without being corrupted. Each one of us, there are limits to what we can do before we, you know, we start getting the big head, and next thing you know, we lose our mind and we fall into a backslidden state. So praise God that he knows those boundaries for each one of us. Praise God. And let's just pray right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, thank you for opening our eyes to what's really going on in this world. Father, we ask you, Lord, to continually remind us, Lord, that we need to wear the garment of humility, Lord God, that we would be humble before you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for your loving kindness, your joy, your peace, your love. Father, just bless us with your Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. We praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen, brothers and sisters. You know I love you. And, you know, I'm just discussing these things because people don't, you know, people's minds are like here. You know, even Christians, their minds are like this. And then people that are looking at what the man's doing, which is what I'm talking about, the man, you know, the powers that be, it really goes to Satan. You know, they're seeing the fruit of all this in the world, but they don't understand the connection. You know, so really I'm giving a, what do they call it, a unified theory. I'm connecting all of this stuff into one to one under one banner, which is the fact that, hey, this is a rise of the new world order. Jesus is coming to put an end to it. You can look back at history with Adolf Hitler and all these other things, Nicholas Roerich, this Henry Wallace, Roosevelt. You can see all these things that they were trying to do, Lenin and all that, and these Ashkenazi Jews who say they're Jews and they're not. I've said Ashkenazi Jews, that's what they're calling themselves, but they're not Jewish. They're just, you know, falsely converted and trying to co-opt and take over and hide behind, you know, oh, we're, you know, they're trying to hide behind the protection that they would have as Israelites and as, you know, and Christians would afford them, you know, love and kindness, as the Bible tells us to do, you know, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem and all that. They're hiding behind that. But in there, you know, they're the terrors in Israel, just like we have terrors in the church. Matter of fact, I would say right now in the last days, the terrors are way outnumber the wheat. And in Israel, you know, there are these tares among the wheat of the nation of Israel, brothers and sisters. But God is the one to sort them out. But we need to see those things for what they are and call them for what they are. Of course, there's the real Israelites. And, if you know, and I just want to say that in balance. There are people who hate on Israel, but you're confusing, you know, the tares and the wheat. It's just like people who are not Christians who say, well, you know, the Christian church killed millions of people under the Dark Ages and and all this kind of stuff under what they call the Inquisitions and all that. No, that wasn't Christianity. Christians wouldn't do that. You know, a house divided against itself cannot stand, as the Lord Jesus Christ said, even though the world always accredits that to Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was just quoting from the Bible. That kind of stuff always irks me. People trying to give credit to some human to what God said. But of course, the people that did the Inquisitions and all that, they were obviously not Christians. Obviously. But it's also obviously true that there was a remnant of God's people throughout, like the Waldensians and all these other groups. But actually, you know, Martin Luther was a Catholic priest. John Huss, go look him up, H-U-S-S, there in Prague. even before Martin Luther, he was a spirit baptized man of God who was also a Catholic priest. So, you know, we see that, you know, God has his wheat everywhere, brothers and sisters. He's got his wheat, and then but there's lots of weeds. And don't throw the wheat out with the weeds, but don't accept the weeds to get the wheat. You know, that's why we need discernment. We need the help of the Lord. We need God's help. We need God's wisdom to make it through these things, brothers and sisters. And I guess that's why God let me make this video and show me all these things so I could bring it together for you, brothers and sisters. So praise God for that. Praise God for, you know, we together, we can figure out what's going on and try to make it and be kind of worthy to escape these things, as the Lord said in Luke 21:36. God bless you guys. Love you. I got another video to make. I'll be back.